Well, it's always controversial. City leaders trying to decide how to spend next year's money.
And this morning, Memphis City Council Chair Berlin Boyd is here with what we can expect this week as you get your first full look at the budget. It's really been leading up to tomorrow's debut, if you will, sort of quiet.
Well, it's probably quiet for the general public, but it's not really quiet for us legislatures. We're just looking forward to actually having an opportunity to see the mayor's budget, to see if there's any raises proposed in the budget, or see exactly what the expenditures are. We know we're losing the $15 million hall taxes. Right. So therefore, we're looking that we're going to have to fill some gaps.
So do you have any hints in your talks that of things that maybe the public needs to hear about?
Well, you know, I think it's going to be a very tough budget season for us. You know, I don't know. It's kind of going to be one of those rob Peter to pay Paul type situations. Mm-hmm. I don't know if the mayor will propose a property tax increase or hint around a proposal of a property tax increase. But we're interested in seeing what the proposal will look like.
Council, one issue that has really attracted some attention in recent weeks has been a proposal by a citizens group mm-hmm. about essentially getting the city of Memphis back in the business of helping to fund Shelby County schools. I think the request involves about $10 million. What are your thoughts on that issue?
You know, Alex, I think at the end of the day, the citizens of the city of Memphis, we're still in the education business simply because we are citizens of Shelby County. We're residents of Shelby County, so we're still paying for our educations within the city of Memphis. You know, like I said, we're trying to figure out ways to replace $15 million lost due to the cut of the hall tax. It's lofty goals. I mean, I really wish we had a blank checkbook where we can fund everything, but we're definitely right now, we don't have the money to go back into the education business. It costs money to do these things. You know, roughly 72% of our city budget goes to public safety. With increased costs, I mean, with giving raises to public safety, those things we can't continue to just do without going up and raising our property taxes. So it's a tough position to be in, not looking forward to this budget season, simply because we have some tough decisions to make.
We've already, in the last few years, seen some cuts designed to fill some holes. Now $15 million is a huge hole. Is there enough more to cut to even make a dent in that?
Well, I know that the mayor has gone through department by department and asking them to cut as much out of their budget as possible. But, you know, at some point in time, Mary Beth, you have to face the reality. There isn't enough money to just cut, or there isn't enough savings that you can find to fill these voids and these gaps. So at the end of the day, you have to go to your source of income. But I think we could do a much better job collecting our delinquent taxes. That will give us additional revenue for the city.
Without increasing taxes.
Yeah. What about spending dollars on things such as the renovation of the convention center? I know a lot of people say, obviously, the money is needed to attract more visitors into town, but do you think it's wise right through here now?
Well, I think it's a great opportunity because, as you know, our convention center has a very few number of dark days. It's a very a resourceful, great building, just needs the revenue. And this renovation will be paid for partly out of TDZ, Tourist Development Zone money, as well as the increase of hotel motel taxes, which primarily is tourism dollars that's coming into the city of Memphis, spending money at their hotels that we're reinvesting back into the convention center.
A couple other things I wanted to ask you about were also Wiseacre. We heard that name, especially when it comes to what to do with the future of the old Mid-South Coliseum.
Correct.
And Wiseacre. Obviously pulled out. So where do we stand on projects such as that, and also the ongoing debate about what to do with the Pinch District?
Okay. Well, you know, Wiseacre did pull out with the Coliseum. It's something now that I think the mayor and HCD is looking at what will happen with the Mid-South Fairground areas as well as the Coliseum. You know, it's something that we must look at. Pinch District redevelopment plan is still moving forward. It should be before the Memphis City Council within the next month. It's already, the plan was already approved in Land Use Control Board. I think it's exciting times happening within those areas in Memphis. A lot of momentum, a lot of positives, or more positives, I look at it, than negatives. We've been getting a lot of phone calls from people being interested or that's interested in developing and moving into the city of Memphis as far as developing hotels. And so it may look dim and bleak, but I think there's light at the end of the tunnel, and it's positive for the citizens of the city of Memphis.
Let's talk about Riverside for just a moment, because even though it's pretty much a done deal that the road for the portion of the road for the play park, as it's often called, will be closed through August, there's some scuttlebutt that it will never reopen, that is a permanent deal. And we just haven't been told that.
Yeah, you're a downtowner. What do you think? What are your hopes?
Well, I've never witnessed something that has had so much backlash. I mean, there are a lot of individuals that's not too thrilled or happy about this. You know, I think it's, in theory, it's a great concept because, you know, you want more people to enjoy parks and enjoy activities downtown. But reality right now is not very wise because a lot of people are not thrilled. A lot of people are afraid of what actually transpired with the shootings that happened downtown. Right. And I've been hearing more and more, well, the more accessibility you give to more people, will we have these activities happening more downtown in the parks? And so I've been getting a ton of emails, a ton of people are stopping me, asking me, can we do something to reverse this pop-up park?
So can we pump the brakes a little bit, or should it continue to move forward?
I think the discussions probably will move forward from here to see exactly. We probably will look at it to see if there will increase any crime levels there, and maybe have a discussion with Riverfront Development.
But as far as you know, at the end of August, it opens back up? Because as I said, there's a lot of scuttlebutt out there that it's never going to open up again.
Yeah,
that
well,
the temporary is just a word.
I think it's one of those things where they were trying. I'm not 100% sure that it will, but it's a possibility that it may.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I look forward to seeing that budget.
Yeah, okay. Likewise.